So restless leg syndrome is a syndrome, which is a signs and symptoms, which are in with regards to RLS or restless leg syndrome. It's an urge to move your legs. Once that happens, the patient or the subject will stand or move their extremities, specifically the legs, and then they'll have an improvement of their symptoms. The urge could be pins and needle sensation in the legs, or what they call paresthesias, which is a more technical term. RLS, or restless leg syndrome, is fairly common. It affects around 5 to 15% of the population. One of the issues is that we, as physicians, have to characterize the process, whether it's a primary RLS or a secondary RLS. The primary ones are usually idiopathic, that means that no cause is known. And the secondary restless leg syndrome, RLS, is usually due to conditions like diabetes, renal failure, or disorders of iron metabolism, like an iron deficiency. The treatment options is supplying dopamine, which is given in a form of a tablet or capsule, and patients that will take medications such as Requip, Meripax, depending on if the patient is able to tolerate the side effects or stay on that medication. In the Penn State Hershey Neuroscience Institute, we have our restless leg syndrome clinic, in which we, first of all, diagnose patients with restless leg syndrome, characterize the process. That means that we review the differential diagnosis, make sure that there's nothing else causing the symptoms, like, for example, the neuropathy, which has similar symptoms related to restless leg syndrome. Also, there's some sleep disorders that are very similar to restless leg syndrome, like periodic limb movement disorder. In our clinic, we have a comprehensive evaluation for those patients to see if there's anything else that is attributing to their symptoms. We also offer them research opportunity if they are interested. Right now, we're working on a research study that involves evaluating the blood flow in the lower extremities. So, for example, a patient who does have confirmed restless leg syndrome and would like to participate in the study, at no cost to the patient, they will be evaluated for any abnormalities in blood flow in the lower extremities. Other potential research projects that we're working on are to evaluate for spinal cord stimulation as an option for treatment, but that's still in the works. I emphasize that patients who do have symptoms of restless leg syndrome to get a comprehensive evaluation for their symptoms. At times, they're on medications, and these do not seem to help. So that's when a question should be asked on whether they do, first of all, whether they do have the diagnosis of restless leg syndrome, or there's another associated etiology that is filling up their symptoms.